lesson in the second semester from the lesson number 11. Okay. So 11 to 13 I have taken. Okay. Good morning, dear students. And very warm welcome in the online education. So now, already we have learned some lessons. Okay, that is what the cell structure and the microorganism. Okay, now today here, we will take the revision of the lessons of lesson number 11, lesson number 12, and the lesson number 13. Okay, the lesson number 11, what? Cell structure and microorganisms. Okay, cell structure and microorganisms. So now here, you know about the each and every substances which is made up from a minute particle. Yes, each and every substances which is made up from the minute substances. But now what about our body? What about our body? The body which is made up from the smallest particle. So what we call this? Yes. So now the things which we can call that is cell. Okay, the cell structure. In this lesson, we are going to learn about the cell structure. How do the cells, what are the components of cells, which are the things present in the cells, right? Next line, man. There is a formation, you can see. See, on your page number 71, there is a flow chart, that is, there is a letter. Okay, whenever the many letters come together, it's form a word. Okay, and whenever the words, many words comes together in the grammatically, okay, it forms a sentences. Whenever the many sentences come together, it form a paragraph, and whenever the many paragraphs comes together, it form a chapter. And finally, whenever the many chapters written in that is form a book. Okay, so these are the formation, these are the flow chart. But the same way about the human being. Next slide, ma'am. There is a structure of our human body. Sir, take a behind one. Yes, thank you. Now, here is how the organization of living things, how our body which is made up from. Okay, so first of all, the minute things or the smallest thing is what cell. But now here, whenever the many cells comes together, it forms a tissue. What? Tissue. Then after, see, you can see over here, there is the smallest particle, the cell. Okay, our body which is made up from the millions of cells. Okay, we cannot say, see, there is a types of animals which we can say that is the unicellular animals, multicellular animals. But if you think about the human body, so our body which is made up of the millions of cells. Okay, the first minute particle, smallest units of the our body, that is cell. Okay, now the next, whenever the many cells come together, it forms a what? That is tissue. Again, you can see when your many tissues comes together, it will works in together, that is form an organ. So in our body, many organs are there. Okay, some are the interior organ, exterior organs. You can see the kidney, heart, lungs. Okay, intestines, esophagus, then brain. These are the organs. But whenever the many organs which comes together and form an action which forms in organ system. Okay, so in our body, number of organ systems are there. You can see your skeletal system, then muscular system, nervous system, blood circulation system, reproduction system, then after excretion system. So these are systems, and just because of these number of systems, the one body is there, that is human organism is formed. Okay, so these are the organizations of living organism. Okay. So again, I'm saying the cells, whenever the many cells come together, it forms together, it forms a tissue. The group of tissues, it forms an organ. The number of organs, which forms an organ system. And whenever the organ system, it works together, it forms an organism. Okay, so these are the structure of our body. But Here the cell is a minute thing, so we cannot see with the naked eyes. We cannot see the, with the naked eyes. So for that, next slide, sir. See, if you think about the cells, okay, so we want a microscope to see the cells. Okay, scale cells is a very small in size. We cannot see with the naked eyes. See, in 1965, a scientist Robert Hooke observed a thin section of cork under the microscope. See, firstly, he used the microscope and he saw a thin section of a cork under the microscope. Now, he gives the name of cells, the smallest particle, and cells, which means it's a small room. The cells, which derives from the Latin words and which means in the small room. Okay. Now here, you can see on the screen, there is a microscope. Okay, so microscope, there is eyepiece, then tubes. Okay, with the help of this microscope, we can see a microorganisms. Okay, so many microorganisms are there that already we have learned, and we'll revise the same. So just because of this microscope, we can see a minute things, we can see a very small things under the microscope. See, there are some objective lenses are there. There are adjustable knob are there. Okay, so here cells are extremely minute in size. Next slide, sir. We cannot see them with the naked eyes. Micrometers and nanometers. See, micrometers and nanometers are units used to measuring their size. The compound microscope used for the observing cells. Okay, an object on a glass slide manufacturing many types of the lens or microscopes. Okay, now these are the cells. But now the cells, we can say cells are in different size. Great variation in the cells we can see. Okay, they are having in the different size. It might be in the circular, then rod shaped, columnar, spiral, oval, rectangular. These are the shapes. Okay. So, each cell contains the various components for carrying out the life processes of the living organism that is called as the organelles. Okay, now see, when you think about the cells, cells is very small things, but in that cells, many components are there. And the components which carrying out the life processes that we are performing regularly, we are performing daily, okay, that is what the organelles. Okay, now here there are some types of cells. Okay, now we are talking about the organisms. That means not under organisms, the smallest part is smallest unit is of organism is what cell. So cells are two types. That is what the plant cell and the animal cells. So you can see on the screen that is plant cell and the animal cell. So here. Both are the living things, so many things are common here, but some are there, so which are present in the animal cell, the same thing which will not in the plant cell. So there is what chloroplast, which you can see in the plant cell, but chloroplast, it is not in the plant animal cell. Okay, just because of chloroplast, the photosynthesis process or the color of the leaves are in green color. Okay. Next one, there is cell wall, chloroplast, cytoplasm, then mitochondria, vacuoles, endoplasmic reticulums, Golgi bodies, cell membranes, okay, then liposomes and ribosomes. These are the components and each and everything which perform an activity, which carried out some activity. Okay, now if you think about the cell wall, next slide, sir. See, the cell wall. See, cell outermost covering of the cell, it is present only in plants. See, cell wall, you can see the picture of plant cell. See, the cell wall only present in the plants and which is outermost cover. We can say the outermost cell wall, it protect the inner, internal components of the cell. Okay, plasma membrane, the plasma membrane, it is also called as the cell membrane. It is known of the thin covering. It is flexible and delicate. it is an outermost covering of animal cell. See, if you think about the cell wall, it is an outermost cover. But in the animal cell, the plasma membrane, it is outermost outermost covering, and it protects the inner part, that is cell membrane. Okay. Next, cytoplasm. Cytoplasm, the liquid of part in the cell, cell organelles are scattered in the cytoplasm. See, cytoplasm is found in the liquid form. Okay. And organelles are scattered in the cytoplasm. Cell organelles, these mainly include the nucleus, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi bodies, ribosomes, mitochondria, vacuoles, and plastid, etc. See, cell organelles. See, rest of the things which comes under the cell organelles. Now, next. Okay, the next part is what? That is microorganism. Next slide, sir. Microorganisms. Micro, the name microorganism. Micro means what? It is in the very small. So you can see on the screen, there is various shapes are there. Okay. The animals only can be observed under the microscopes. So organism means what? We cannot observe with the naked eyes. We cannot see with the naked eyes. So if you want to study, if you want to observe the microorganisms, so you have to use a microscope. Okay. We cannot see with the naked eyes. It is found in the unicellular, multicellular, in a cluster. See, the cells which you can see in the in a single cell, that is which is found in the single unicellular animals, then multicellular, the example of unicellular, that is amoeba, multicellular animals, let me say the human body, and the it is in the cluster. It is generally found in the unicellular animals, multicellular, and it is in the cluster. Okay, it is present all around of us in the water, air, food, sewage, garbage, well, as well as body of the animals and plants. See, you can see our microorganism where it can be grow. Okay, so it can be everywhere around of us. It might be in the water, it might be in the air, food, or garbage, sewage, and all body of the living thing. Okay, next slide. Now here, growth of microorganism. Each microorganism needs the specific environment for the growth and reproduction. Okay. See, growth, how the microorganism, they takes place, their growth. Okay. So, the medium is what? Their soil, water, decaying matter, etc. These are the medium. That means what, where they can be growth. They can produce their new one. Some can live without oxygen, or many require oxygen to survive. Yes, some microorganisms which can live without the oxygen, or many are there, they require oxygen as like us to survive. Okay, next, the some are the survive extremely conditions. See, many microorganisms, they can be survive in the extreme condition. It might be higher temperature than the example like the ocean floor, ice in the polar regions, and hot water spring. Ocean floor, that means what, many varieties or many diversity you can see in the ocean floor. So there are there also the microorganism can be there. Ice in the polar regions, so polar region, okay, at the polar region, the temperature is very cold. It is near about minus 30 to 40 degree. Okay, so in that condition, there is also microorganism and the hot water spring. So in the extreme condition, they can survive. Now we have the temperature, it is about 25 degree to 30 degree Celsius. And the nutrition, what specific nutrition, that is what, algae or chlorophyll and the oxygen. And atmosphere, okay, our atmosphere is moist, humid and warm. Next slide, sir. Now, according to the shapes, the life processes, microorganisms are classified as algae, fungi, protozoa, bacteria and viruses. See, as per their shapes and the life processes, as per their shapes and micro processes or life processes, we can say, it is classified algae, then fungi, protozoa, bacteria and viruses. Okay. Now, these are the things, but they some microorganisms are useful to our human body. Okay, so how they are helping? Okay, all types of milk products just because of the microorganisms. Okay, Microbes are useful for product to producing the milk product like the butter, buttermilk and the cheese. Okay, it works as the antibodies. Okay, many of the times doctor suggested us to give the antibodies. So antibody, it works against the antibody. Microorganism. That means what? It increase our what? It increase our immunity to fight against the bacteria. Now next, vaccine is produced in the laboratory with the help of microbes that increase the immunity against the disease. See, nowadays everyone is talking about what? Everyone is talking about the vaccine, corona vaccine. But what is corona vaccine? What is vaccine? So vaccine is which is made up from the microbes in the laboratory. Okay, now you may saw that is the polio. Okay, immunization. Then many types of vaccine are there which is made up from the microbes or microorganism. Okay, have you ever heard of the yogurt? Okay, so the things yogurt, we can say butter or buttermilk, which is just because of the microorganisms, there are some changes. What? There are changes has been takes place just because of microorganisms. So this type of microorganisms we cannot see with the naked eyes. So what? For if you want to observe, we has to what? We has to use a microscope to study the microorganisms. Now here, antibodies are useful for curing certain diseases. See, antibodies which always help to curing the certain diseases, they can be harmful if used without consulting a physician. See, there is one more information has given. You have to be keep always remember. Okay, what? So antibody, it is always helps to body, but you have to take the with the help of consulting the physician. You cannot take the without the consulting of physician, because of it will be it will get hurt your or it may harmful to your body. Okay, hence the course of antibody should be completed strictly following the doctor prescriptions. Okay, suppose you are feeling you are suffering from the fever. Okay, so again for that doctors use some medicine or antibodies. So it has to be strictly followed. It antibodies mean which works against the diseases that you are suffering. Okay, now we should not take the any medicine in our own or treat like the body aches, headaches and common colds. See, nowadays what we are doing, suppose you are suffering a headache. So what you are doing? Okay, take a medicine of that is painkiller and you are having, you are consuming. But it will be harm you. It might be harm you. So better way you have to take the help of what? The physician. Okay, now next slides. See, now here, some are the harmful microorganisms. Many of the times you may saw the your food has been spoiled just because of microorganisms. Okay, you may fall ill with the disease of the alimentary canal like the typhoid, cholera, hepatitis and gastro. Yes, these are the diseases just because of the microorganism. So many of the time as they are useful, so it is also harmful to our body. Okay, now next. Now here, some information has been given here that is regarding your food. Okay, eat fresh and properly covered food. Eat only the fresh food, which is properly covered food. Drink the boiled water. Always you have to take the drink boiled water. Hold a handkerchief over your mouth and nose when you cough or sneeze. See, when you cough or sneeze, so you have to use a handkerchief. Okay, now don't allow garbage and water to accumulate around your house. Don't be stored your water and garbage near about your house, because of that you will get the bad smell, or you can say just because of this dirtiness the moisture will be there. So another thing, so first of all, when you are consuming the water, so you have to be think about the things, the is the water tank and the water in it clean? So what the water that you are consuming, you are drinking, so is it clean or not? Are the water tanks and toilets are in the school clean? Then is the water and accumulation in pots, tires, can, etc. around house drained properly? So you have to take care of this. Next, are the water storage container clean regularly? Water storage, that means what? The tank, your water bottle, your pots in the house which you can store the water. So it is properly clean or not? So you have to take the all the things in your mind. Next slide, sir. Okay. Now here we'll go to the next lesson, that is what the muscular system and digestive system in the human being. So earlier I said in our body many systems are there, okay, which perform a number of organs in the one muscular system. Here you can see the muscular system. So you can see in the picture there is a bicep you can see. Yes, muscles are bundles of fiber that can contract and relax as required. See, muscles, our body which is made up from the muscles, whatever you can see, that is what muscles. Okay, number of muscles are there in the body and it can be contract and relax as I require. See, in this picture you can see he bent his hands from the elbow. So there is a contraction and relaxation of the muscles. Muscles are firmly attached to the bones by means of tendons. So tendons is substance which attach to the bones. Okay, next slide, sir. Okay, well, we can say here, types of muscles. See, there are some types of muscles. We can say there is a voluntary muscles, involuntary muscles. Okay, so voluntary muscle means what? Working with our hands, walking, eating, running, etc. are function that depend upon our will. See, the movements which are depend on will, which depend on our desire. If you want to perform activity, that is voluntary muscles. Okay, suppose you want to write something, you want to write. So writing is an what? It's an activity, but it's a voluntary activity. Because of writing, it's an voluntary, that means depend on your desire. If you want to write, you can write. If you don't want, you cannot write. That is what depend on your will or depend on your desire. Okay, but next is what? Involuntary muscles. Involuntary, the various processes like breathing, blood circulation, digestion are vital functions. They are essential for life. They do not depend upon our will. Okay, now the muscles of organs which carry out these involuntary muscles are called as the involuntary muscles. Function of organs like the stomach, intestine, heart are the carried out in their own fixed manner by involuntary muscles. See, here we can see the activities which cannot be depend upon our will or our desires. The function that is blood circulation process, which takes place continuously. Your heartbeats, okay. Then after your digestion system, digestion. Okay, so these organs are working continuously or it is not depend upon wish. Okay, so many of the time we feel when you put your hands on your chest, so what will you observe? There is some movements. It is the movement of heart. It is not on your depend. That is involuntary. Okay, so many organs which takes place in this activity, that is kidney, it always filter the liquids, then heart, it always pumping. Okay, so these are the things. Now, the types of muscles. Next slide, sir. See, there are skeletal muscles, smooth muscle and cardiac and heart muscles. So these are the types of muscles we can say. So skeletal muscle means what? The two ends of each the muscles are attached to different bones. Example, such muscles are muscles of the arms or legs. Their movements are voluntary. They are also responsible for holding the bones of the skeleton together and giving the shape to our body. See, skeleton muscles, it gives a particular shape to our body. And characterize one, the two ends of this muscle which attach to the different bones. The example is what? Your hands and legs. Okay, their movements are voluntary. So earlier we learned about the voluntary muscles. Voluntary means what? It's depend on your wish. This smooth muscle, okay, smooth muscle, the example of that is the heart and the stomach, the intestine. And the heart are cardiac muscles. Okay, cardiac muscle. Yes, with the with these muscles, the heart is made. Now, near about the cardiac muscles causes our heart to relax and contract continuously at the rate of 70 times in per minute. As I said, when you put your hands on the chest, so it the movements you can see it is in 70 times per minute. Okay, now next one is smooth muscle. So these muscles are present in the internal organs, that is what muscles of the stomach, intestine, blood vessels and uterus. Okay, smooth muscle, where you can find the examples, that is uterus, then intestine, stomach and blood veins. Okay, now next slide. See here, muscles in the different parts of the body. Muscles in the different parts. So you can see in the picture, there are biceps, triceps. Okay, so the muscles, they always works in a group. Even some muscles contract, other muscles, the same group relax. This is how muscles help in the proper performance of the various function of our body. See here, we can say that quadriceps, okay, flexors, then biceps, triceps, chest muscle. These are the types of muscles you can see in the human body. Next slide, sir. Next point is what? That is digestive system. So digestive system, it contains a, that is mouth, which is start from the mouth, then pancreas, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum, anus. These are the organs are taking place in the digestion systems. Okay, digestion means of the conversion of food into soluble from the its observation into the blood is called as the digestion. It consists alimentary canal and digestive glands. See, digestion system consists alimentary canal and the digestive glands. That means what, when you are consuming the when you are chewing the food, so there is a gland which secrete the digestive food or digestive juices. It may help to digest your what you have consumed. Okay, this is digestive system. Next slide, sir. In the next slide, you can see here many organs are there. That is mouth, then pancreas, which is in the throat, then liver, small intestine, salivary glands, esophagus, pancreas, small and the large intestine. So we, each and every body is there performing their own function. Okay. Next slide, sir. See, there are some important glands which secrete at a particular place and their function. Okay, so in the organ, that is mouth. So gland is what? Salivary gland. It secretes what? Saliva. And just because of saliva, whatever you have consumed, it will be help to digest the food. Okay. Now here, next. Here some next slide, sir. Here some information which is given about your health. That means, sir, are you putting our health at the risk? Yes, when you are consuming the alcohol, yes, you are smoking, you are consuming that tobacco. Whenever you are having this bad habit, that means, sir, you are at the risk of your health. You are putting your health at the risk. That means, sir, there is an instruction or warning for you. Don't consume this type of substances, that is alcohol, then smoking, then tobacco. It may get cancer. Okay, it may hurt your life. Okay, so we have to be take care. Next slide, sir. Now, yeah, the last one that we can say, that is changes. Okay, see, you can see the many type of changes, that is natural changes, useful changes, harmful changes, fast and quick changes, slow changes, reversible, irreversible, periodic changes and non-periodic changes. These are the types of changes. Okay, some changes we can see by it's happened by naturally. Many of the time we make into a, another form, that is wood. We make the furniture. That means that we are changing the form of these substances. Harmful, some are harmful changes. Some are quick changes, basically. Quick changes. The firecrackers, it's one of the most important example of quick changes. Slow changes, Okay, next slide, sir. Now here we can say that is physical changes and the chemical changes. Okay, so what we can say the physical, suppose the melting the things, melting, boiling. Okay, these are the physical changes or chemical method. There is corrosion. Corrosion is one of the important example of chemical changes. Now here corrosion is what? When an articles rust, a reddish brown layer from on it, greenish layer is seen to form a copper articles. This process is called as the corrosion of metal. See, you can see the corrosion. Corrosion means what? You can see the greenish layer on the metal. That is corrosion. Things become weak due to the corrosion. See, when when the substances or metals are stored for a long time, so you can see there is a thick layer of brown color or greenish color. So it may damage or it may weak the substances just because of the corrosion. Yes, corrosion is caused by the oxygen, moisture, vapor of chemical in the air. Okay, these are the things which are always effect for the corrosion. Next slide, sir. Now here, see, you can see here, there is a picture of metal. So on that metal, there is a brownish color of layers. Okay, so just because of this, it becomes a very weak, the quality of that metal is getting reduced. Okay, so these are the things which are always affect, that is what oxygen, moisture, vapor and the chemical in the air. Next slide, sir. Now, in this way, we have learned, we have revised actually three lessons. That is what? The first lesson, that is the muscular system in the digestive system in the human being. The next one is the muscular system changes, physical and the chemical changes. Okay, now your lesson, the first is what is cell. Yes, the definition already is given. So what is microscope? Okay, write down your answer in the chat box. The next one, tell the name of smallest cell. Yes, see, you saw many types of cells are there or many shapes are there, but which one is the smallest cell? Okay, that you have to be right. What is unicellular animals? What is, that to whom we can call the unicellular animals? The next, what are the bad effects of microorganisms? See, there are effects, the good effect or bad effect. So what are the bad effects of microorganisms? So you have to be right. Name the movements of muscles. Okay, so which movements you can do? So write down the movements of the muscles that might be a voluntary or involuntary. Now, function of small intestine. What is the function of small intestine which takes place in the digestive system? Okay, now next slide. We are at the end of this lesson, that is homework. Next slide, sir. Yes, now take a screenshot of this page. Okay, there are some questions you have to be complete as a complete. Okay, this is a new homework. Now, okay, I hope all you have enjoyed the lessons, and this is the revision of three lessons. Okay, so thank you. Thank you so much for attending lessons. Yes, and have a good day.